Ask yourself, how far should you go to reduce risk? And how do you know if you've done enough? If you work in a major hazard industry, then you've probably heard the word Alarp before. But what does it actually mean? Alarp stands for as low as reasonably practicable, and is a measure of how far we should go to reduce risk. Risk being the combination of the likelihood of a major accident occurring and the severity of its consequences. It can often be easy to decide how far we should go to reduce risk. The likelihood of an office fire is big enough that most will have fire exits, fire extinguishers, emergency signage, and provide you with a safety induction upon arrival. These barriers are proportionate to the risk. But what about an example of a barrier that is disproportionate to a risk? Let's take, for example, a meteor strike. Now, the risk of your office being hit by a meteor strike is incredibly low, because meteor strikes are, thankfully, pretty rare, which is why we haven't built underground bunkers for us all to work in, as that would be disproportionate to the risk. The trouble is that it isn't always as obvious if a safeguard is proportionate to the risk, and that's where Alarp comes in. It helps us to decide whether or not we need to be doing more to reduce risk. In the great majority of cases, you can demonstrate that you've reduced risk to Alarp if you're following good practice. So what do we mean by good practice? Well, no matter which industry you work in, there will likely be people who have done your job before you. They would have learned from their mistakes and made decisions about how best to do their job safely next time. This experience helps to drive improvements in regulations, guidance, and standards. These are good practices which you should follow, and this is usually a determination agreed with industry bodies or regulators. Even if you have considerably reduced risk, you must still follow good practice. So whatever field you work in, it is essential that you understand what is regarded as good practice, as that must always be followed. If you're unsure, then you should ask your employer for help finding out what good practices exist for your role and industry. If a decision can't be made using good practice only, then it can be done so using first principles, where you can demonstrate that the costs to reduce risk further are grossly disproportionate to the level of risk reduction it provides. Think back to our example of working in underground bunkers, and this is known as cost-benefit analysis. Once we have completed our risk assessments, implemented our barriers, and followed good practices, the risk that we expose our people or the public to falls into these three areas, where the risk is unacceptable, where no matter what, you must reduce risk further. Broadly acceptable risk. Whilst you should still reduce risk if you can, you've likely sufficiently reduced risk. And finally, the tolerable if Alarp region, where all risk reduction measures proportionate to the risk must be put in place. The earlier that you consider risk and Alarp, the easier it is to implement additional barriers that you identify. And that's why it's important to complete risk assessments early. To demonstrate Alarp, your risk assessment should include a record of the additional barriers that you considered but chose not to implement because they were disproportionate to the risk in relation to the benefits that they would have offered. Without that, there isn't any evidence that you've reduced risk to Alarp. And this is often missing from risk assessments, and it shouldn't be. If you want to remember Alarp as a single sentence, then you can ask yourself, what more could we do to reduce risk? And can we justify why we aren't doing it? The thing is, achieving Alarp isn't a guarantee that you won't have an incident, so we must remain vigilant at all times. Keep challenging yourself, what more can be done to reduce risk? So what did we learn? Alarp stands for as low as reasonably practicable, as a measure of how far we should go to reduce risk. To demonstrate Alarp, we must ensure risks are not in the unacceptable region, that we are following good practice, and that we have implemented all barriers that are proportionate to the risk. The best practice for risk assessment is to document the barriers you considered implementing, but did not because you concluded that they were disproportionate to the risk. You must always keep challenging yourself to reduce risk further if you can.